So if you're thinking, oh, geez, I don't remember those. Well, good thing we're taking a day to practice a little. As I said, maybe I didn't say it. Test is 2 sets 75. 75 is continuity. So assuming you studied and memorized the definition of continuity, you should probably be good there. Show limits in your work. 74 is fluid force. That's the older ones, not the newer ones. Don't get it confused with work. But you should definitely study that it's rho dA and have that in your head. 73, then we come to the 73. 73 was the antiderivatives of log base A and A to the X. I'm not huge on studying, but those are facts you probably won't have at your fingertips for a test. Are you with me? So those would be study facts. What is the antiderivative of A to the X? A to the X over natural log of A. And what is the antiderivative of log base A of X? Yeah, okay, so you don't have to show any work here. If you remember, cool. But the idea came from changing the base from log base A to natural log. Log base A is natural log over natural log of A. Natural log of A usually gets factored out front. And then how do you integrate log of X? It's ultraviolet root. It's x log of x minus x plus c. Now, I don't want you to show me the ultraviolet voodoo on a test, especially that would be a time eater. If you had to, you were in a pinch and you didn't remember it, you could do it, but I prefer you just know, recall. Yeah? So with that said, let's start showing the relationship. What's the VA relationship? V is the derivative of A. You should, again, can you that? That's the thesis for the problem. If you anti-differentiate 2 to the t plus log base 2 of t, then what is the antiderivative? 2 to the t. 2 to the t over natural log t or natural log 2? 2 plus, and what's the antiderivative of log base 2 of t? 1 over natural log of 2. T natural log of t minus t plus a constant. All right, if I use the initial condition 4, 1, 4, 2 over log 2 plus 1 over log 2, 1 log 1 minus 1, I can't read my own writing. 1 log 1 minus 1, what does 1 log 1 minus 1 come out to? Just negative 1, yeah. Okay, so in essence then, 2 log 2s minus 1 log 2 is just 1 log 2, right? So what'd you get for C? If you have 4 and you move over a 1 log 2, 4 minus, not log 2, I should have said 1 over log 2, sorry, 1, 4 minus 1 over log 2. And therefore your answer is that big mess with that C in it. Obviously, don't do that on the test, but in the interest of time, you understand what's going on. Yes? Yep? Yes. Okay, cool. Let's go to... go to box 7, please. And this will be slightly different. Would you find the area of the region between y equals negative 1 over x squared plus 1 and the x-axis on negative 1 to 1. No calculator. Okay. This is just like this. There's probably something like this in the homework that there were errors on that.
Are you ready?
What do you know about the region?
Well, if you are not sure, who can you always ask?
Matt. Yeah, you can always ask Matt. What does that mean?
So, what does the graph look like at negative 1? Negative 1, when x is negative 1, y is? Negative 1 half. At 0, y is? Negative 1. And at 1, y is? Negative 1 half. Okay, so we're looking at that area, yeah? Okay. So if you integrate what kind of answer will you expect?
Yeah, I don't need to integrate that to know that's coming out negative. Why?
Below the
x-axis. Below the x-axis. Okay, so on set 20, number 70, set 75, number 20, 60, so set 75, number 20, there's a question that said, find the third quadrant area enclosed by this curve. And people said, okay, here goes my integral. Now, that right away I was going to be mad. The question was just how mad. Now, the people that did this and found negative one-third, I was a little mad because you said the area is negative. When you find area, it should be positive. What really made me mad is the people that set it up this way, but they said the area is one-third. Now, to me, just so we're clear, two negatives, when you're doing this, they don't make a positive. Two negatives make a big old U state, okay? This is wrong, and now, not only did you set it up wrong, but you integrated it wrong, or you got a negative and you took out the eraser. Now that really, really frustrates me, because you knew it was supposed to be positive, but you didn't care enough to do anything about it besides erase the negative. That ticks me off, all right? So instead, actually ask yourself, I'm getting something negative. That's not right. I better go back and figure out why. Just so we're clear, these are rectangles. That's a height and that's a base. If these go left to right, how is x changing? In a positive way or a negative way? Positive way. If I go left to right, x is increasing, x is changing in a positive way. So with these this way, what's the x? It is positive. We're good to go there, okay? What about the heights? The heights are negative. There's no way I'm going to get a positive area when one of the components is negative. You're not setting it up properly. You need to make sure the bases are negative, positive, because the limits go the correct way, and the heights are positive, and the heights come from not just slapping a function in there, but saying upper minus lower, or how do I make it positive? Oh, I need to flip it up and negate it. Or so I should see some kind of negative, not at the end, but at the start, to say, I know those heights are negative, and I need to address that problem. Understood? Okay, so in this case, then, this you know is going to be negative. It shouldn't be this way. You should say, this is a question of area, and so I need to make it positive. Right? I need to use the opposite of the y values, or if you like, 0 minus the negative, whatever you want. Just so you are making the whole work come out positive, not just the answer. What is that antiderivative? This should definitely be on your study facts. What's du over u squared plus 1? Arctangent of u. If you don't know that, study it. What's du over root 1 minus u squared? Arc sine of u. Okay, so in this case then, you're talking arc tangent of x from negative 1 to 1. What is arc tangent of 1? Pi over 4. What's arc tangent of negative 1? 3 pi over 4?
No.
No, lava's not. Negative pi over 4. If you say 3 pi over 4,
you know, ended in the lava zone, right? So your answer is? Pi over 2. If you use 3 pi over 4, how should you know that's just totally bogus? Because if it's 3 pi over 4 there, what kind of answer do you get? You get negative. That's not good. Okay. So, make sure that you take steps to make a positive area, and you'll make me happy. Next thing. How much time do we have? We have 11 minutes. Let's go to 20, please. Would you go to 20 and divide the box down the middle? The first thing I want you to do is take the derivative of arc sine of 2x implicitly. Okay. On the homework, I have been frequently putting in the box, do the work implicitly, and people are just going to write the answer. That's not implicit. That's looking it up and recalling it. Started, what's the first step after you, I created an equation with a y so you could write it implicitly. Now what? Sine of y equals 2x. So the idea is you're having an implicit equation, which is to say y is implied, not explicitly clearly stated, but implied within. Now we take the derivative with respect to x. What is the derivative with respect to x? Sine y dy dx equals just 2. Dy dx is 2 over cosine y, yeah? Okay? How do you replace back for cosine y so the derivative is in terms of x? You draw a triangle based on this statement. Y is the angle. I know it looks like 2x and only one side, but it's actually two sides. What sides are being given? Opposite is 2x and hypotenuse is 1, and therefore the adjacent by Pythagorean theorem is minus 4x squared. With that triangle, we can replace cosine y with its equivalent in x terms. What is cosine y in x terms? Square root of the adjacent side, 1 minus 4x squared over hypotenuse is 1. And there you go. Okay, so just so we're clear, again, I'm trying to warn you ahead of time. If the problem says, show the derivative implicitly, and you're big on memorizing, I know arc sine derivative, and I know the chain rule, you will get 1 point for the answer, and minus 4 for the, you'll get 1 out of 5. So if you're cool with 20%, go for memorizing. All right. So I expect the process. Let's go to part, the second half of that box. I also expect you to be able to manipulate integrals that result in arc trig. So let's call it, let's beef that one up a little bit and call it 5 dx over root 4 minus 9x squared.
already have dx, never mind. Okay.
You want to give this a go on your own? Or do you know enough to start this on your
own?
Okay, go for it. Okay, so did you get 5/3 arc sine of V halves x plus c? Yes? Yay. Okay, let's try one more. Would you go to box 17? And I'm going to replace that one. 17, consider the region R enclosed by y equals the square root of x plus 5. The x-axis and let's go plus 4. The x-axis and the y-axis. It's revolved around the y-axis. Find the volume. If it's around y-axis, are you using x or y?
Well, it should definitely be y. If your integral's in terms of x right now, you're conceptually off. Okay. The radius is the function in y terms, yeah? That completes the negative. That's okay. We'll finish going over on Monday. Your homework is to do everything else on this. And we'll go over questions on both this one and 30, or whatever. We'll go over both on that. 77 and 78, right? Okay. Have a good weekend. Yes. Oh, super, thanks. You're welcome. Have a good day. Thank you. You're welcome. Have a good day.
I got you.
No problem.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Have a great day. Boys meant to be. Boys meant to be. What's your name, kiddo?
PJ.
PJ, lingua? Landua. Boy, did I butcher that. Sorry. Landua.
I got you, I got you.
Yeah, you're right. What's your name, Connor? Connor. Your name is Connor. Ferris.
Yep.
did, they wrote it down to finish it. This will be looking at the side. Hi, how are you?
A Julian?
Julian.
Hi.
Cool, thanks.
Yeah.
Hi, guys.
Will you just put it up on your hands?
Yes.
Thank you.
Oh, I was getting you, that's just. Okay. Benfield.
Hi.
Hey, how are you?
Good.
Good. Really?
Your fencing?
Blakey O'Connell.
Here.
We got.
Sorry, you just have to stick a few more. Who? Oh, I'm sorry, you take the room. Which one are you doing?
Oh, here.
I already got you marked with that. Oh, sorry, you guys shouldn't have, you guys gotta figure out who's doing it. I just was taking things for later, but now you're adding it up.
Did you finish Dennis?
I finished, I actually just finished the room, which I didn't.
Alright.
Am I missing any big ones?
I don't see any trouble.
Any concerns in it?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we don't.
Crying darts right here.
Crying darts right here? Hello?
Andrew.
That's Mason.
Who?
Mason is gone for. Probably.
It's like perfect timing, and I hooked up one of the angels, and he's like, "Chips, some chips." I'm not eating chips. Not chips.
Gypsy.
Oh, I thought you said chips.
Alright, we're gonna go down to the cafeteria. Here's Rick.
You're welcome.
I just felt like.
You guys gonna meet each other eventually, I guess?
I thought it was.
Okay. See you guys. Do you need anything for me?
No. Pull that as tight as you can.
Is somebody gonna hold your hand so you don't have any stuff to put on there?
And also, we're gonna be random and ask. Hey.
I never.
No, you're just like. I was like this.
I
I do, yes, thank you. I don't have a box, I just threw it.
Oh, that's all.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
No problem.